determination that whether we win or lose, we have applied the best of ourselves to the task at hand. So the last couple of weeks have been now very frustrating, a lot lonely, sleepless nights. So this was a project which we may or may not be able to do in our lifetime. So we got an opportunity. So I thank the Reconstruct team, Sandeep Charan Shraddha ma'am, for giving us an opportunity to work with this kind of project. So, firstly, I would like to thank the Reconstruct team for giving us this opportunity. And secondly, I would like to wish all the teams best of luck, since everyone has put in a lot of effort and sleepless nights. Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Madan Kumar. Currently, I'm undergoing the corporate on-job training in Reconstruct. I'm in MS20 Composite Group. So I'm the team leader of Group 3. So the project which we got was GPS-45. So this is the biggest and the most valued project in all the groups. Huh? So I would like to thank all the mentors who literally sat with us and helped us whenever we needed. They sat with us, literally hours together to get the project done. Huh? So these are all our mentors, Sandeep sir, Shraddha ma'am, and our engineers, Aparna ma'am and Tuthagar Vishwas, Swapnil and Mukram Reza, and obviously the one and only BIM engineer, Prakyan sir. So actually, I am very lucky, to be honest. I got a good team who coordinated very well, and we did not have any ego issues. The thing was, we equally distributed the works and everyone put their lot of effort. And especially Jackson, huh? 1 week he didn't sleep. So let me introduce my structure team. I'm a part of structure team. Pratap. This is Pratap. Deepak. Sayed. Chetan, Rahul, these are all our structural engineers. And coming to BIM engineer, Mr. Jackson and Mr. Sankey. And Krishna was unable to come due to some reasons. So this is GPS-45 residential building, which is located in Mulund, Mumbai. So let me give you a brief introduction about it. It is located in Mumbai, Mulund area. So the number of floors was GPS-42. Plus, there was a OHT and there was a sky lounge. Yeah? So the number of floors GPS-45, the total height of the building was 151.35 meters. So the width of the building, the tower which we designed, was 25.26 meters and the length was 77.01 meters. So the interstory height was 3.36 meters. So the grade of concrete which we used was M30, M35 and M40. And the grade of steel for the reinforcement was FE500 and FE415. The SPC which we got was, as per the geotechnical report, it was 80 tons. So that is almost equivalent to 785 kilonewton per meter. And the total cost was 243.37, okay, including land cost. So next I would like to call upon Mr. Rao Chetan to explain the architecture plan.
Well, thank you, Madan. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I want to thank the team for their utmost dedication and especially our mentors who helped from the back of our stage, and all to provide like special accolades to Sandeep sir and Shraddha ma'am. Thank you. Yeah, I'm Chetan Ali. I'm a MS22 structure engineer training from Reconstruct Design and Private Limited. Today I'll be dealing with the architecture floor plan of our GPS-42 building. First of all, generally we know that what is a floor plan, right? It is a two-dimensional graphical representation of a building layout on a horizontal slice cut through a specific level. Architecture sees that at sea level and the structure sees that at roof level because they need the pavement column layout. So, but what are the functions of this architecture floor plan? It helps us to visualize the space, rooms and the physical features which can be easily viewed from the above, and it helps us to visualize how people can move through around these spaces. So, but architectures would have undergone through several iterations, and like with circulation flow of people for the space they are provided before we get the final draft for the structure engineering to start the project. This is a building consisting of both regular and premium apartments. Why we have considered both regular and premium apartments? What is the need for this? Because the real estate industry has seen the resurgence of both, has seen the resurgence of luxury market over the last few years. But there is a continued growth, there is a continued demand for the regular apartments, for the people with middle income growth. Right. So about real experts in the real estate market as seen or optimistic for the demand of both kinds of apartments. This is the insight why they have included both regular and premium apartments. Coming to the building, so this is the ground floor plan of our building, and up to 32nd floor it is the same plan, and there have been few changes because of refuge air inclusion and service floor area. So this is a ground floor plan of our building. On the either, this is symmetrical actually, the mirror image on both sides. As you can see, two BHK flats on each wing. The ground floor, before that, the ground floor plan has been divided into two wings, wing A and wing B. The two BHK flats has been provided on either side of the building, and three BHKs at the center, two BHK. For the purpose of accessibility, they have provided three lifts and two staircases at each wing. Yeah, thank you. So this is the general highlights of that floor. The, you know that these will be there, of course. Three BHK, the main highlight should be that in the three BHK they have provided one master bedroom with dressing room along with WC or bath. Next. Yeah, this is the same floor plan of the ground floor plan, but they have included refuge area. Generally, we have refuge floor area in all kinds of building. As you can see that in this case, they will be designed in order to occupy the occupants of the building in case of emergency, like fire emergency. So in this case, they are provided at 7th, 14th and 22nd and 29th. The size of two BHK flats on either side of the building, on the bottom side, has been used as the refrigerant in this case. Service floor area, it is a floor consisting of components pertaining to maintenance of heater, water pipes, or air conditioners, and elevator engine rooms, etc., or any other supplementary rooms. They are provided at 20th and 40th floor. Thing is, the height, the floor-to-floor height of the service floor is 1.8. Since there will be restriction to the other occupants of the building, only the persons who are pertaining to maintenance are allowed to enter into this building. Considering the average height of the person, it's around like 5 feet, 7. Yeah. So they are provided here 6 feet. That should be okay. Yeah. Here comes the above 33rd floor. It will start with premium apartments. So the thing is, let me go. From 33rd floor, they are providing up to 42nd floor, the premium apartments. 33rd and 34th floor are the duplex, and again on the last 41st and the 42nd, they are providing duplex floors. Here, this area from above, they are used as the area for terrace with paddle pools on either side of the building. So this is duplex and this is duplex. This is a single story floor with the premium apartments. Next. So let us deal with some of the premium apartment ground floor plans. Yeah, this is this side of the building. On either side, it is a lower duplex floor consisting of 7 BHK flat. And at the center, they have provided 6 BHK. This is, there are 3 bedrooms. Here they have provided 4. On the upper floor, they have provided 3. So this is 7 and 6 BHK flats. So this is the upper duplex floor where they have provided gym, sports room, study room, sorry. The floating gym, the study room along with the bedrooms for the 7 BHK flat. Yeah. So this is the general highlights of the 7 BHK and 6 BHK flats. Yeah. So yeah, again from 35th floor, they have provided a single story flat along with the paddle on either side of the building. As you can observe here, sorry. So this is the parallel pool area with the terrace, along with the 3 BHK flats. Okay, next slide. Yeah, this is the overview of the our 3+42 building. So these are the number of flats, like 2, 3, 5, 7, how many lower duplex and upper duplex have been provided. Yeah. Next, I will call upon Mr. Deepak Tibakar to continue the presentation. Thank you.
Good morning to all of you. First of all, thank you, Sandeep sir, Sharma, and all mentors who supported me. And I'm just talking about modeling. Modeling is initial part of the buildings or projects. So modeling, in the modeling, this is a 3D rendered view. I'm talking about material properties. Material properties in concrete. Concrete, we are using concrete M30, M30 grades, M35 grades, and 40 grades we are used, and longitudinal rebars, confinement bars also used in buildings. Section properties, we are talking about beams. Beams casted in M30, four types of beams provided in projects, and slab M30 casted, and three types of slabs provided in projects. Shear wall casted is M40, and different thickness provided, and said spandrel costed M30, and three types of spandrels provided in this project.
क्या आपको उसकी बुद्धि क्यों हो रही है फ्रॉम कॉर्नर सो आई टू हियर आपको बाहर में मैकेनिकल दिस वन सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन ऑन समथिंग ऑफ बिल्डिंग व्हिच आई हैव लर्न डेड लोड्स इट इज कैलकुलेटेड बाय द ईटैप्स ऑटोमेटिकली एंड वी आर गोइंग टू लाइव लोड्स इट इज कंसीडर्ड एज आईएस 875 पार्ट 2 Now these are the floor area type and dead load and live load factors. And the load assigned on beams, frame loads. This is the formula for the distribution load, thickness of wall into height of the wall into density of the material used. So material RCC and glass. So density of RCC is 25, density of glass is 0.5. So now going to beams, frame loads. So we have type of walls. The height, thickness and density. The total calculation of the frame load will be getting distributed loads. Now going to analysis A. Now I am telling the details of the seismic analysis. As per IS 189/2016, the building is located in Mumbai. It comes under the zone factor 3, 0.16. So importance factor is 1, I is equal to 1.2, clause 7.2.3, table 8 says that if number of persons more than 200, we should consider as 1.2. In our case, the project contains more, in our G+42, the number of persons around 1200. So response reduction factor R is equal to 4, it is a structural frame wall. Time period T is equal to 0.09H divided by square root of T for the infill wall. So you get the TX value and TY value. And this is the base shear of dynamic spec X and spec Y. Next, Mr. Abra going to explain about the wind analysis.
Thank you all. First of all, good morning everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank Mr. Sandeep sir, Swetha ma'am, and my dear mentors for helping me to figure out all these criteria for this project. Now, my name is Sayed Abrar Hussain. I am from MSC 21 batch structure. I will be explaining about wind analysis. The height of the building is 151 meters, so it is governing dynamic wind effect. We have checked both in wind static and dynamic also. For that, we have taken mean design speed of the structure is 50 years. Why? Because all general buildings and structures, as per code, it says we have to take the value of k is 1, and the basic wind speed in the Mumbai, since we are located in the zone 3, we have taken it 44 meter per second. Risk coefficient k1, as per clause we have said design wind speed for 50 years, we have taken k value as 1. Terrain category depends upon the K2 value depends upon the terrain category, which is terrain category 3 and class C, which says that the height, surrounding height should be less than 10 meters. We have to take terrain category as 3, and class C is, since we have 151 meters building, we have taken as structure class C. Topography features, as the IS code says, the slope, it depends upon the slope of the ground. We have taken 0 to 3 means we have to take K3 value as 1. Wind analyze. The wind analyze we have done is according to the formula, wind speed. We have to calculate the wind speed and pressure, H by W and L by W value, wind watt coefficient and leeward coefficient value from the table. We are getting 5.98 and 3.04. We have calculated that, and according to the ETAs, they will give the direct values. For the dynamic, we have to find out the gas factors and all. We have done all the calculation based upon the criteria we are coming. VZ is equal to hourly wind speed meter per second, and regional basis wind pressure is 33, and K1, K2, K3 value are by the same wind basic share also as per IS codes, and the for the gust factor forces along WX and WY, we have calculated the values as CF into A into PZ into G, where CF is a force coefficient in both the direction X and Y, where A is effective frontal area and PZ is equal to wind pressure, which is given by 0.6 VZ square, where VZ square is equal to horizontal wind speed, and G is a gust factor. These all CF value will calculate by tabular column, which is figure number 4, A by B and H by B factors, and A effective frontal area will calculate by floor to floor height, and PZ value as per 0.6 into VZ square. From that tabular column we can get all the values. For G, coming to the G point, we are tables from 8 to 11 tables, we can get the size reduction factor, background factor and gust factor. We can also put the values, and for beta value, since the nature of the structure is RCC, we have taken 0.016 as that. From that we have the gust factor value, and we will find out the forces along the wind X and wind Y. We got the base share. We have compared both static and dynamic also. 4,546.75 kN in static, and we are getting a same as 16,357, which is more than two three times more than that in dynamic. And in wind wise, 18,341 kN in static, and in dynamic 41,675, which is very more in dynamic. Because since it is governing in building is governing wind direction in Y, that's why it's more.
Stability checks is nothing but is a decision made of whether the structure is stable or not, as per Indian codes. And this is an inter-story drift. You may see that the graph is something different. So most of we see first time like this, even me. This is because of service story in 20th floor, so that drift is varies in that floor, but it's also passing as allowable is 0.004, and it's passing in X and Y direction, and this is the service floor. We are using shear walls around the outer boundary, so that the drift is for that graph, and the displacement against the earthquake is coming around 1395, and in X direction and Y direction is 72.77. It's passing in X and Y direction. Since it's a wind governing building, so that we facing lot of problem in to passing this wind,
since the section sizes are increased about 500 to 600 thickness, wall thicknesses, then it's passing in wind displacement in x and y direction, but it's critical in y direction, but also it's passive. This is a model table, is nothing but a, it's a tabular form of tabular form which tells building behavior by the lateral forces of earthquake and all. This is the time period we got 4.12 for the first oscillation of the building, and next is 3.79, so it's coming around 10%, so it's not a closed space mode. Then we got mass participation in more than 65% in third mode, and rotation is itself pure translation mode. We got 0.1%, and next immediate mode is the translation mode, that we got 42%, and we increased up to modes 30 because of the model mass is coming very less. Then we increased up to 30 modes, then it's coming more than 95% for the modal mass participation. This is the deflection shape of the building for the dead 1 and live 1 combo. And we got maximum deflection at terrace floor. We checked it and it's passing. And the span of that slab is 4.86 meter, and it's coming under allowable deflection. And the torsional irregularity is generally in our building, it's symmetric in x direction and unsymmetric in y direction. So it's in y direction it's coming torsional irregularity about 4 meter of center of mass and distance between center of mass and center of rigidity, and we considered in design. A good soft story, the similar case we faced in DIRT, the same reason for this also. We faced the soft stories came in 2012 because of that service lab that we considered in the design. It's the buckling. Since our building is 151 meter, so that the lateral dimension is least dimension is 25.26, and it's coming 6 meter. Sorry, 6 ratio of h by v is 6. Since we have to do the buckling analysis, and we considered in design. This is the design check, and every member is passing. And we did the shear wall detailing, and we considered 25 mm bar, 18 numbers, and 150 mm spacing. Since it's a very 151 height meter building, so we used 500 mm thickness of shear wall, so that we considered 25 mm of rebar percentage in rebar in longitudinal rebar, and ties we used 16 numbers and 10 mm on 250 center to center. Since it is shear wall in lift portion, we took it as a for example. It's a section for in elevation view. Since the vertical lines are longitudinal bars and the horizontal lines are shearing bars. Thank you. The next part will continue with the.
Thank you. So now I'm going to explain the design of underground tank. This design is done in SAP 2000 software. So the dimension of the tank is 8 meter, 6 meter height and 6 meter width, and one tank size. We have two tank 1 and tank 2. So one tank dimension is like 9 meter length and 6 meter height and 6 meter width. So these are the materials used for the underground tank constructions: concrete and rebar, M30 concrete and Fe415 rebar. And these are the sections property: bottom slab, top slab, and side slab. Now soil pressure load. The uniforming load from top to bottom 0 kN per meter square to 130 kN per meter square. As seen in the water pressure load, we have top load from top to bottom 0 to 60 kN per meter square. Now this is the soil pressure. The soil pressure, you can see the arrows coming from outside. This is the soil pressure from the outside, tank 1 and tank 2. And this is the water pressure from inside. This is the deformation shape due to the soil pressure and water pressure, tank 1 and tank 2. And these are the bending moments, sidewall and reinforcement of bars and spacing are in vertical and horizontal directions. Same as in bottom slab, top slab, reinforcement as bars and spacing in vertical and horizontal. And this is the detailing of a tank in a section elevation, and that is a cross section elevation. Now I call upon Mr. Sankey to explain about the 2D electrical plan.
So I will be explaining about the foundation. So for any building to be stable, the foundation is a must, as Sanjeev says. If your foundation is very strong, you can construct your GPS 100. So since ours is a 42-story building, so we need to design it properly and safely. So these are all the materials and these are all the FZ values, the actual forces. So the concrete which we used was M40, rebar 2500, and the SPCR code is 80 tons per meter square. So this is the size, this is the layout of the ramp which we have given. So it's a 3 meter ramp. So almost one story height of ramp we have given. So okay, you can imagine the age. So these are all the checks which we have done. So the ground bearing pressure, so it was 80 tons. So the we got it as a 560 cylinder per meter, that GBC. So it is less than 75 since it is safe. Then, so this is the settlement for any ramp. The maximum settlement allowed is 50 mm. So for the maximum it was 36, for the service level of minimum it was 45. So since this, there was settlement issue, so we had to increase the area of the ramp. So the punching shear, since we used the M40 grade of concrete, the allowable shear was 1.01. So now when we checked all the punching shears, so it was well within the 1.1 Newton per mm. So it was like around 0.7, 0.9. Ranging from 0.7 to 0.9. So this is the stresses. So the crack width. So the finally crack width. So we did take the average, and the allowable limit was 0.2 mm. So the crack width which we got was 0.13. So this is the maximum minimum for the service and all. So this is the crack width calculation for 0.162. So the reinforcement which we gave was at the bottom, we did give a 32-watt 50 mm spacing, that is 3 layers, 150 mm spacing, 32 mm, and at the top one layer 32 mm bar 100 spacing. Since our foundation engineer was not able to make it, so our structural mentors, especially Aparna ma'am, that has been us whole day, and she helped us with it, and Swapnil and Arez also. So next I would like to call upon Sankir. So the soil structure interaction, once you do the shape, so you need to analyze like when the building is resting on the ramp, how it will act. So that is known as soil structure interaction. So after the soil structure interaction, actually 123 members failed the beams, then we rechecked it and redesigned it. So and it is safe. So this is the percentage of the beams which we did after that. So the 2D electrical plans will be explained by Sankey.
First of all, good afternoon, everybody. And I want to thank to Sandeep sir and Shazam for giving us the greatest opportunity, and all the mentors also. Thank you so much. So now I will be explaining the 2D electrical plans and 2D plumbing plans. First of all, why we need electrical plans in the construction project? Because it helps us to visualize the electrical system. It also helps the electrician to design, install, or repair electrical system. So let me go through this, what it might include. First of all, how the electrical wires and other parts are connected to each other, and where the electrical components and the fixtures are situated, we can find through the electrical meter. Now I will move to the electrical plants. This is the typical ground floor plan, which has the 4 2 BHK flats at the corner of the building and 2 3 BHK flats at the center of the building, and the electrical room, which has the main supply, which is distributed to the over the building, is situated right next to the building. So I will be explaining the one of the 2 BHK flat to you in the next slide. So this is the one of the 2 BHK flat. This is living room. We have the entrance from here. So as we see in the living room, we have provided 6 ceiling lights, and along with the 2 ceiling fan and 1 AC unit, 1 TV unit. Moving to the passage, we have provided 1 ceiling light. In kitchen, we have provided 2 ceiling lights and 1 exhaust fan. In bathroom, we have given the 1 lamp, 1 geyser and 1 ceiling light. In bedroom and master bedroom, we have provided the 2 ceiling light, 1 ceiling fan, 1 AC unit, 1 TV unit. So what we did in this, we have provided the AC unit in every bedroom and living room. So we have given the 1 MCB to the AC because it has a higher voltage. And we all the AC units, all the MCBs are connected to the main MCB, which has the, which is the bigger MCB. Just like this also, geyser units also connected to the main MCB, and all the switchboards which we have provided of the lights and fans to the main MCB. So what happens with this MCB? Because if any person wants to go out for the sound. If anybody wants to go out without switching off the every room's light, he can switch off from here only. We can cut the whole room's electricity. So which is so this MCB is connected to the main meter box, which is then connected to the electrical room. So I am explaining the next 3 BHK plan. So it is similar like this also, like 2 BHK. In bedroom we have provided a similar system like as I explained before, but in the living room we have given the 4 lights, ceiling lights and 2 ceiling fans, and here also we have provided the main MCB, which is connected to the meter box and which then is connected to the electrical room. So this is the typical floor plan of the refuge area. So in this, everything is similar, but the refuge area is different. So I'll be showing only the refuge area to you. So this is the refuge area. We have only provided the ceiling lights, not other any electrical equipment. So we have provided minimum ceiling lights in this. This is the one of the lower duplex plan. Which is the very similar as the all the typical plan, which has the 3 BHK, 2 3 BHK, which is similar to the all the floor plans, but the different is the this portion. So I'll be explaining you the this portion, which has the 4 BHK plan. So basically only difference in this plan, it has the very big living room area and the paddle pool, which included with the this paddle pool area. Rather than other things like master bedroom, bedrooms are the similar, including kitchen. So only living room area we have provided. Because of the larger area, we have given the this amount of lights, 9 lights, ceiling lights and 4 ceiling fans and 2 AC units, which is then connected to the, and in this area we have given the 2 main MCBs, which is connected to main MCB is connected to this portion, 1 main MCB, and 2nd main MCB connected to this portion, and which has a 2 meter box, which is then connected to main electrical loop. Next. These are these components which we have used in the this electrical plant, as I shown before, the bracket lights, exhaust fans, and etc. These are used in the plans. So now this is the plumbing plans. This is the typical ground floor plumbing plan. So plumbing is similar in every plan. So I'll be depicting the one of the bedrooms, bathroom to you. So basically, these are the lines which we have provided. In this, we have the water closet, flower drain, one tap, and one sink. But in this, we have provided the solid waste water pipe. Wastewater pipe, cold water pipe, hot water pipe. Solid wastewater pipe is connected to the water closet. Flower drain is connected to the solid wastewater pipe, which is then connected to the water tap also and sink also. In hot water, cold water pipe, which is connected to tap, sink, and water closet also. But the hot water pipe is only connected to the tap. Next, this is the OSD floor plan. Which has we have a 2 OSD which is has the capacity around 324,000 liters and which is then distributed by the other floors which we have shown the distribution. Next, we have also given the underground tank which is situated right next to the building. Which has the storage around 648,000 liters, which can store up to 4 days of the water. These are the components which we have used, as we explained, as I explained before. So now the 3D electrical and plumbing plan will be explained by Mr. Jackson.
So good afternoon, all. As a part of my curriculum, I am handling the MEP part. So before starting MEP, I want to, it's my indeed pleasure to thanks to Mr. Sandeep sir and Shraddha ma'am to giving this opportunity and effective this more acting effectiveness. So I will explain about the electrical and plumbing. So already Sankesh has explained about in 2D drawings, is switches, lights, AC, TV units and everything. So I will explain about the materials which I have provided in the Revit model. So this is the AC with brand in the LG. So this is what this is the 230 volts provided. And this is the ceiling lights. This is volts actually 20 to 30 volts. And the main panel board is actually 680 watts that is coming, that is connection from the Karnataka electrical board line to this main panel board, and after it is distributed to the other panel boards. So this is the wall length and this is the MCB panel which we are providing to the room wise to distribute to the all rooms connection. And this is the plumbing part. So I provided in 2 generators in this building. The one generator capacity is more than 1 lakh volts because the whole building current capacity is 7 lakh. So I provided 2 generators. The brand of generator is Atlas Corpo. So comparing to other generator, it is very good actually. So water heater, that brand is higher actually. And the WC sink. So in the cooking room, I provided the stainless steel sinks. So it will be no rust and nothing is there. So it is the water pump which is provided in the underground tank. The water supply goes to the OSD. And this is the plumbing and architecture plan which we are putting to the Navy's work. These are the clashes actually. And these are which actually these were resolved. So next question will be explained by Mr. Madan.
So the most important aspect of coming to Bill of Fund is the money. So I'll be explaining you about the floor wise material takeoff, like how much it will cost. So this one goes actually we have used like 5 to 6 types of doors. So the material is given, the door 1 and door 2 is African decor, the door 2 is aluminium and the other doors are glass, clear glasses.
Then the windows, same as that aluminium glasses we have used. So we have used three types and the flooring. So the total cost per floor was 9,65 for the doors and 4,50,000 for the windows. And the flooring rounded up to 8,77,000 as we used granite and triple tiles. So these are all the plumbing fixtures and mechanical equipment which we use. So basically we are concentrating on MEP, right? So these are all the MEP fixtures. So the plumbing fixtures, water closet, sink, tap. So there are the brands of Indwell, Royal Safari, Jaguar, Budget. So it depends on the client. So next, coming to mechanical equipment, we need the AC, fan, pump and generator. So the total cost for the plumbing fixtures was 2,36,000 and mechanical equipments 40 lakhs. So in that 40 lakhs actually generators, only two generators for the whole structure has been used. So for the whole building, give us 45 to high quality and high energy saving generators have been used. And the electrical equipment, so lamp, ceiling light switches. So that rounded up to 72,000 per floor. So these are all the plumbing reducers, elbows, the extra stuff other than pipes. So plumbing bends, reducers, elbows, T's. So that is like 900 or 5,000 or something. And the T's. So roughly it estimates to about 40-50,000 per floor. So this is the main structural takeoff, structural quantity takeoff. So as you can see, since we used 125, 150 and 175 different thickness of slabs, so we have taken the quantities. So including the rate, price is like 5,800 and the cost 1,65,000, 1,67,000 depends on the slab type. Right? We have calculated and given the shear walls, since we have used shear walls, the concrete required was more. So based on the thickness and we did calculate the volume multiplied with the price. So the total structure cost, that is slabs and shear wall, ended up to 22,96,000. So the wrap foundation alone cost us 5 crores, 25 lakhs, and the other so these are all the steel quantity, like for superstructure and the quantity for the substructure. So this is the total area statement. So G plus 42 square meters, G plus 42 the normal stuff, the normal typical floors. So 36,138 meters. So the total cost per floor, that is MEP, mechanical electrical plumbing, it ended up to 42,28,506. So that multiplied with the 45 the total value. So these are the rendered images. Beautiful, luxury. So that is the skyline I was talking about. This particular image. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. So what did we learn from this week? I mean, this couple of weeks. Firstly, handle frustration. Was in this. Coming to learning, actually, so we got a GPS 45, right? So actually, the modeling issue was we were not able to provide the shear wall since there were windows in X direction. So there were big windows, like 2.34 meter tall, that big windows, even bigger than those. So only in Y direction we provide shear walls. So 5 structural engineers were there and we were doing it. Rotation was like 65%. 5 different people are modeling it and we are not able to figure out. Then we went to Sandeep sir. Sandeep sir was like, why don't we provide spandrel? We were like, why did you think of that? Then with few spandrels, the 60% rotation came to around 8% with just few spandrels. So this is the process of learning which we learn. Like we went to different mentors, so they gave their perspective. The total perspective like which we have was very limited. So when we went on working on this project, when we went and met mentors, they gave us different view. So we got to learn, okay, that why didn't we think of this? We came, okay, this is how we do it. That is how we gain the knowledge. And coming to the nitpicking. Ours was only i5 generation, sir. i5, 8 gen, 9 gen. Do the changes for 2 minutes, run the analysis for 40 minutes. We were so frustrated. Do the analysis, go for a walk, come. Go have dinner and come. So this is how it happened. So you just learn to be patient, teamwork, and that's it. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you for the support and all the other things.
Yeah, excellent slideshow. The design I really liked, actually. Very good, Mr. Madan, Chetan, and all other guys. Actually, I don't want to take the name of each individual person, but everybody has done the good explanation. Raft explanation also was very good. Explanation regarding the sizes of the elements that you guys have chosen, that was also very good. The underground water tank explanation and design, what you have done is also fantastic. Nevis works, clash detections and all also was amazing. Finally, the BOQ, actually, it was also very good. Overall, yes, it's a really good performance that you guys are doing. Coming to a few questions. So, what was the IRR ratio that you have calculated? Any investment versus the returns?
Actually, we did calculate, sir. So, the total cost, the construction cost ended up to around 150-160 crores.
Okay.
So, the land, we valued it at 10,000 per square feet for Mumbai. So, since we calculated based on the built up area, so we planned it for around 10,000, that is the nominal range. So, the carpet area was around 15,000 square feet. So, that ended up around 650 crore odd. So,
okay.
It takes around 3.5-4 years to construct. The investment is almost double, 2.5.
Okay. So, have you done any survey of the pricing over there?
Yes, sir. We did the survey, sir, like high-rise structures especially. So, the starting rate for the high-rise structure, you know, the carpet area starts from 15,000, it goes up to like 20-25,000 per square feet.
Okay.
That was the carpet area per square feet.
Okay. And what is the cost of the construction with the land that you are getting?
234 crores, sir. So that
no, per square foot, I'm saying.
I need to calculate.
Okay. Few other questions, actually. Any, because, see, it's not like a square shape. It is purely a big rectangular shape with longer in the, the aspect ratio is also quite high. So, any challenges for the wind analysis?
Sir, it was very challenging.
Yeah, and how did you find out actually to figure it out those challenges? That's the question.
Actually, as a team, we got a lot of help from the team members and also. It was governing in Y direction because frontal area of the in Y direction was more, that's why it's governing in Y direction. We compared static and dynamic also, it was like 3 to 4 times more than static, sir.
Okay, okay. And finally, what was the deflection against the waste gust factor?
Gust factor, sir.
Yeah.
In dynamic, it was like 2.3, sir. 0.3. Deflection.
Deflection,
sir, we are getting first allowable is 294, sir.
Okay.
Then we have increased the shear walls and all. Then we got allowable deflection as 292, sir. It was
okay.
Passing in wind direction.
So for what was the sizes of the shear walls initially you were given at the
500, sir. 500, 400. Depending upon the floor, we have
reduced that.
Yes,
sir. So you turned the value.
Yes, sir.
It's really good. Please give
one more thing, sir. Actually, the gust factor we are not able to figure out. So, this guy literally done 6 times gust factor. With help of everyone, 6 times gust factor value calculation is there. And everyone has modeled like minimum 2-3 models they have modeled again and again. So, endless though.
Okay.
So,